Cobb's own county, Mr. Bernard Wrigley.
Thank you. Good afternoon. Jolly nice to be here. And I was watching the lads with me tongue out, because when we were that age, we couldn't play like that. I can't now. But I do remember when I was just about that age, and I've got my first concertina, and I went on a holiday to Weston-super-Mare for a week. Christ knows why. I must have lost a bet or something like that. But why would you go there for anyway? I do remember that on the pier there was a sign. It said, "Tonight, the Vernon Adcock Spectacular Talent Show." So it said, "Come along and you can sing." So I went, and I'd been playing a little concertina for about 4 weeks, and I went along and sang this song I'm going to start with, and I came second, which I was quite pleased with. But the bloke who came first was 87. Not that there's anything wrong with that, but he was 87, and he sang "The Windmills of Your Mind" with his hands like that in operatic fashion, and he sang, "Round like a circle in a spiral, like a wheel," wobbling with a vibrato. Well, Christ, he's no chance. And he came first, so I was a poor second. But I'm going to start with this song because it's got a great opening line, really. "Good evening, all me jolly lads. I'm glad to find you well." Good opening, isn't it, that? And written by Dominic Behan. The man, his brother wrote the plays, Brendan. Brendan wrote the plays, and Dominic wrote the song. Christ, me straps.
You've not lost your polish,
Bernard. No. Not yet. How'd you go on, girls? Oh, that's it. Right. That's near, isn't it? That'll do for me. I'll take me Dewey off and... you can tell this is new, there's only one piece of Dewey on there. So I did bring my bass concertina this afternoon. I thought I'd bring my bass guitar instead. So we laid it in the hollers and we laid it in the flats. If it doesn't last forever, sure I swear I'll eat me hat. Well, I wandered up and down the world, but sure I never felt any surface that was equal to the hot ash. Oh well, good evening all me jolly lads, I'm glad to find you well. If you'll gather round me for a while, the story I will tell. I've got the situation and begotten begot. I can whisper I've a weekly wage of 19 bob. Since 12 months since October, since I left me native home, to helping in Killarney boys to bring the harvest down. But now I wear a gansy and around me waist a belt. I'm the gaffer of the squad that stirs the hot ash belt. Well, we laid it in the hollers and we laid it in the flats. And if it doesn't last forever, sure I swear I'll eat me hat. Well, I wandered up and down the world, but sure I never felt any surface that was equal to the hot ash belt. Well, the other night a copper comes and says to me, "Maguire, would you kindly let me light me pipe down by your boiler fire?" He planks himself straight down in front with his hobnails up to late. I said, "I'm a decent man, you'd better go and mind your beat." He ups and yells, "I'm down on you, I'm up to all your pranks. But I know you for a traitor from the Tipperary ranks." Well, I hit him from the shoulder and I gave him such a belt that he landed in the boiler full of hot ash belt. Well, we laid it in the hollers and we laid it in the flats. If it doesn't last forever, sure, I swear I'll eat me hat. I wandered up and down the world, but sure, I never felt any surface that was equal to the hot ash belt. Well, we quickly pulled him out again and threw him in the tub. And with soap and warm water we began to rub and scrub. But the bugger the thing had hardened, sure it turned as hard as stone. And with every other rub, sure you could hear the copper moan. I'm thinking, says O'Reilly, that he's looking like a Nick. And burn me if I'm not inclined to clean him with me. Ah, says I, it would be easier to boil him till he melts and to stir him nice and easy in the hot ash shell. Well, we laid it in the hollers and we laid it in the flats, and if it doesn't last forever, sure, I swear I'll lick me hand. Well, I wandered up and down the world, but sure, I never felt any surface that was equal to the hot ash shells. Now you may talk about your soldier boys, your sailors and the rest, your shoemakers and your tailors, but we please the ladies best. You're the only ones who know the way the flinty hearts to melt are the lads around the boiler stirring hot ash fell. But with the rubbing and the scrubbing, sure I caught me death of cold, and for scientific purposes me body it was sold in the Kelvin Gold Museum. Now I'm dangling by me belt as an erection to the Irish stirring hot ash fell. Well, we laid it in the hollers and we laid it in the flats, and if it doesn't last forever, sure, I swear I'll leave me hat. Well, I wandered up and down the world, but sure, I never felt any surface that was equal to the hot ash fells.